All right, got this guy back, all this dumped back inside of this pot. In case you guys didn't see the last video, I tried to make some grape jelly or grape jam and I did it wrong. And I'm thinking I should have boiled the skins to thicken up the jelly and then, or jam and then strain it out. But I didn't do that because I was winging it a bit too much. And instead, I'm gonna use some sugar gel. The recipe said that I should be able to just do it like this. Without any pectin or anything added in, and it should have been thick enough to be jelly, but it was not. It was kind of a paste sort of a thing. So I'm gonna put this guy, this whole packet in here. This is enough for half of this. Last year I did this and I totally botched it, and I ended up putting in way too much pectin or something, and my grape jam turned out to be rock hard. Well, not rock hard, but it was like taffy. It was quite distressing. So we'll put this guy in and we'll let this thicken up. I'm just a huge fan of winging it. You can barely see the little saucepan over there. Let me move the camera over. All right, got my jam over here. Got just some hot water over here. We're gonna pump this up. Stir in some of this with a nice whisk. There we go. Stirring this stuff in. Something like that. So any of the water I put in here, I'm gonna have to boil off, which sucks. Boiling off water takes forever. All right, here we go. We'll let that, we'll get this up to a boil. Got this guy on some medium heat here. So we're gonna bring this up, this pectin water, up to a boil. And then we'll pour it over into the jam. Gotta keep stirring both these pots. Both pots. Sure, I'm gonna get a lot of old ladies on my previous video telling me I'm an idiot. But that's all right, Grandma. That's all right. I'll figure it out. Something like that. Come on. Heat up. All right. Got this pectin water. Start to boil. Supposed to boil it for 2 minutes, apparently. Stirring constantly. The water running is the jar's canning pot being filled up with water. And they're tipping over because they're trying to float like idiots. Okay, gotta boil this for 2 minutes apparently. Hopefully that's gonna get rid of a lot of the water in here. Been about 2 minutes. Go ahead, turn this guy off, pour this over. Okay, just pour this straight in apparently. Get all my pectin in there. Then, I'm gonna stir this up. Get that pectin spread out. Please, please thicken up. Got my hot water all over my jars, my little funnel, and a ladle in there, just to make sure those are sterile. I'm gonna have to go get new lids because last time I ruined the jelly didn't set. So I used the lids, and you can only use the lids once if you can with it. I've got a little vacuum system, and I'll probably do a video on that separately about how to, you can use those old lids to store things like nuts and grains and stuff like that. But anyways, I have to go get some new lids and put those on this new batch of jars. Okay, got my lids over here. The water's not simmering yet, but I'll get that up to a simmer. I'm just gonna keep stirring this jam and pray that it thickens. Yeah, so one of the things I thought when I was new to canning, I mean, I'm still pretty new to canning, but when I was even more new to canning, I thought I might need spare rings or something like that. But as it turns out, when you, after you've done canning it, you put it in your jar, you take the ring off and leave the lid on. So you have all these extra rings lying around. So you really don't need any spare rings because you're going to end up with a whole lot of extras of those and probably just chuck them away anyways. What you do need are extra lids, because every time you can something, you need a new lid. There are some reusable lids, like the Tatler brand. I've never used those, but I've seen quite a few people who like them, and I've thought about getting them, but they are like, I think they're like $2 a lid or something like that, so it ends up being pretty pricey once you, you know, you got like 100 jars or something like that. But I would like to get those because they last much, much longer than these do. You know, they're many use, and these are, these metal style are just one-time use. I would like to know if anybody knows what the old, what they used to do with jars way back in the day. So there must have been some sort of wax or something that they put on it instead, and they probably bought it locally or produced it locally. So it would be interesting to know historically how people like settlers and stuff like that would can when they've got, you know, they don't have a store or a Walmart they can run to and buy some stuff. I would like to know how they can things that far back and how sustainable it was for them. Okay, got my jam back up to a boil. Gonna follow the directions for this pectin and hope that it sets the jam better this time. Alright, since I cooked it so much last time, I don't think I need to cook it too long here. I'll probably just cook it for something like 10 minutes just to make sure the pectin is all whatever it might do. And then we're gonna ladle it into jars. Alright, I figure I'll move these over. These jars aren't quite to boiling yet, but that's okay. I'm definitely going to have it boiled once the jam is actually in the jars. So let's ladle this stuff over. Get this down lower so it's not bubbling so much. Okay. Pull my ladle out of here. Into this boiling hot water. That was a genius idea to put that in there. And my ladle, my funnel here. Okay. There we go, those jars are starting to pick up a bit. Okay. For this guy, like this, over here. This guy over here, something like that. Let's get the actual ladle in there. Okay. If it doesn't thicken this time, I think I'm gonna have to add a whole another thing of pectin in there, something like that. Grab my magnet, pull a lid out over here, put this guy on like that, toss a ring on, hold it still like this, there we go. Okay, move this over. Okay. Another jar, funnel, my lid's over here is starting to bubble a bit too much, so I'm going to pull the temperature down. I want them boiled. Something like that. Probably not supposed to do that. Oh well. So my wife's a pretty picky eater. I'm expecting that she's not gonna like this grape jam. Just a guess. Educated guess. She does love raspberry jam though, but our raspberry plants really don't produce much. Looking good. Doing a good job at not getting these the rims of these jars covered in anything. Down to my last jar here. Don't have much left. Bottom here, probably a jar and a half's worth, I'd say. Something like that. Now, don't put on these lids, these rings super tight. Apparently, you don't want it too tight. End up damaging it, anyways. Okay, I'm gonna have to forgo the ladle. It's getting too low. Just pour this straight in. Okay, there we go. This last bit, you know what? I'm not gonna put this last bit in a jar. What I'm gonna do with it is I am going to try and make some fruit leather out of it. I've got a dehydrator. I mean, there's a little bit left in there. Might as well see what it does. Okay, got all my jars over here. I've got a bit too much water in there, so I'm gonna grab a cup, kind of ladle some of this off. Dump it in the sink, because this will probably overflow, and it's heavy anyways like that, so. Might as well not get it too heavy. All right, it's probably good. Let's put this lid on, let it get to a full boil, and we'll boil it for 15 minutes. Okay, that water's getting to where it's starting to boil. I'm just gonna pour this straight on this fruit leather guy here. No idea how this is gonna work. No idea how it's gonna turn out. Just kinda wanna see. Cup extra, might as well experiment. Got the temperature set to 135. Hope that's good. All right, we're at a nice rolling boil on this guy. Start the timer for 15 minutes. 15 minutes. All right, let this go. Added an extra 10 minutes for altitude. Let's pull these out. They're gonna be quite liquidy right now, so I won't be able to check if they set just yet. But I think they did. I mean, bunch of sugar, bunch of pectin. You'd think that'd thicken it up. Pretty excited to see how the fruit leather turned out. All right. See how this fruit leather turned out. I don't think that this worked. I checked on it a little bit before and it's just kind of gooey. So you can kind of see that it's just kind of pulling up. And I haven't tried to peel this off or anything yet, but yeah, it's still just, it's just terrible. So I let this go for something like 24 hours and the texture was about the same. So obviously just taking jam and trying to turn it into fruit leather does not work, but I was just curious. This is just an interesting experiment. So lesson learned, that doesn't work. Well, just had one of them pop, so that's good. This is all of my grape jam from this year. I've got these on a towel here so they don't crack when they touch the cold counter, relative coldness compared to the inside of there. Another one just popped, so that's all working out pretty good. I'll get back to you guys in a couple hours, probably like 12 hours or something like that once these have cooled down, and we'll see if they have set. All right, here we are with our completed jam. It turned out all right. It's still a little bit gooey here. If I tilt it over pretty far, it kind of starts to move a bit, but it's really quite good. My wife and I tried it. She actually really likes it, so that was a bit of a surprise, but that's good. So I guess this video is gonna be how to fix some runny jam or something like that. I'm pretty happy with this. It's been years and a couple of times trying out this jam with these grapes that I have, and this is the first year it's been successful making jam with this. Let me show you last year's jam. All right, Here's some jam from last year. It's kind of hard to see on camera, but this is much more opaque than this. This is much more clear. I think I might have not kept nearly as much of the skins in there, but it is far, far too thick. Let me grab a little knife and show you. All right, check this out. It is just, it ends up being really difficult to spread on the bread. It's kind of like a glue. So it tears the bread apart as you try to do it. Like with this knife, it's really not too bad, but with how thick this is, look at that kind of shape that it forms there. It's like kind of a taffy, but it ends up destroying the bread as you try to put it on there, which is pretty depressing because the flavor was really good, but the texture was all wrong. All right, well, I hope you guys enjoyed this series of videos. I hope you guys got a good laugh at me. This has been definitely a learning process for me, but I think next year it'll go much more smoothly. Trying to make some grape jam, I'll probably just clean this guy out and toss it since I've got a good comparison of that. But hope you guys enjoyed this. Please remember to like and subscribe.